Good morning. Today we're here with Anthony Lozado Gardner, the former ambassador to the EU. Thank you for your time, Mr. Gardner. We have a couple of questions. The first is, how do you think the dynamic of the US-EU relationship has changed since Trump came into office with an isolationist agenda? And furthermore, how do you think Trump's presidency has affected the strength of other populist parties in Europe?
Well, great questions. It's still moving, right? We've seen evolution. The first few months, I was very worried, to be honest with you, because we saw a radical change. From 60 years of bipartisan Republican-Democratic policies toward Europe, toward integration, toward European Union and its predecessors, right? And I say specifically bipartisan because what I'm about to say is not at all a partisan statement, because my Republican predecessors, my job as ambassadors to the EU, and I would probably agree on 90% or more, right? We've supported European integration for a long time because we thought, and we still should think, that it's not only good for Europe, but it's good for us, good for our exporters. It's been good for our investors in Europe, and it's been good for a stable, democratic, prosperous Europe with whom we can partner on a lot of issues, regional and global issues. Now, I say I was worried because in the first few months, there were a lot of signs that this administration was having a radical rethink, right, and believing that the EU was at best irrelevant, at best irrelevant. In fact, the president said so in an interview in which he said, I'm indifferent as to whether the EU succeeds or fails. And secondly, there was a view, there still is a view, that the EU is only a trading bloc. It's not more than that, which is also a caricature. It's not true. It does a lot more in political and security affairs, in development, humanitarian aid. The list is very long, right? Now, to be fair, there's been an evolution, a positive evolution, right? But still, I don't think the EU is being valued properly as a partner by this administration.
Going off US-EU partnerships, TTIP was an agreement that you worked hard to pass during your time as ambassador. What effect do you think Trump's dismantlement of the agreement will have for the European and American economies?
Well, it's uncertain what future that agreement has, at least during the next 3.5 years. So, the European Commissioner for Trade, Cecilia Malmström, did go to Washington. She met with Secretary of Commerce Wilbur Ross, and they had a discussion about TTIP, in which I was very involved. But it's very clear that it's going to be complicated. It's not going to be quick, and it won't be easy. You know, first the administration said, well, we're not really interested in a deal with the EU. We're interested in other deals. Then they kind of said, well, maybe it's an interesting deal, because they realized that other deals are actually even harder. But some of the key issues in TTIP, which made our life difficult, like in government procurement, like agriculture, a long list of things, have in fact become more complicated, not less complicated, even for this administration. Because the president said, for example, in his inaugural address, I will make America strong by protection. I will hire America and I will buy America. Those will be my two rules. So if you listen to his rhetoric and that of his advisors, TTIP has become really, really tough. So it's on ice. I hope it'll come out off ice, off the ice pack, and we'll be able to do something with it in a couple years' time. It's important. Mm-hmm.
And finally, how do you see the structure of the EU evolving in the midst of Brexit, where it's clear that member states have many different interests in being part of the EU and may want more or less sovereignty?
Yeah, that gets back to actually part of your first question, which I didn't answer, you know, the impact on populism in Europe. You know, a lot of people worried, and I actually also worried, that the Trump victory would have put a lot of wind in the sails of other populist movements in Europe. It hasn't happened, obviously. We saw Austria, we saw what happened in the Netherlands, and obviously in France most recently. You know, it's interesting because it appears that it's had the opposite effect along with Brexit, because of the 27 arguably have never felt more united than they have now, because they see the consequences of the Brexit vote and now what's happened to the UK economy, which I think is linked. They look at the Trump administration. The Pew Institute had a recent poll which showed a very, very low percentage of Europeans trust this administration to do the right thing. I mean, it's just fact. Again, it's not a partisan statement. So they're pulling together in a way they've never done before. And it's interesting because in European history of integration, that's typically how Europe has taken leaps forward, by external pressures and external threats. It used to be the Soviet Union, right? Now it's migration. Now it's the economic crisis, it's the Trump administration, it's terrorism, etc. All those things are making Europeans work more together.
Great, thanks so much.
Thanks.